But thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left, and thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles, and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. Fear not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither be thou confounded, for thou shalt not be put to shame, for thou shalt forget the shame of thy youth, and shalt not remember the reproach of thy widowhood any more. For thy Maker is thine husband, the Lord of hosts is his name, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, the God of the whole earth shall he be called.
To reclaim our power, we have to dig deep. We can no longer afford to focus on surface matters. Surface matters bring confusion and division. You have to go beyond the surface to get to the root of your problems. Focusing on the surface is a waste of energy. When we bicker back and forth and shift blame, that is surface problems and a waste of time. The Most High do not want his people to engage in debates and foolish arguments.
But foolish and unlearned questions avoid, knowing that they do gender strifes. But avoid foolish questions and genealogies and contentions and strivings about the law, for they are unprofitable and vain.
Debates and foolish arguments only bring forth division and confusion. Dealing with demonic oppression on the surface level brings temporary relief. Anything can disturb the peace and the problem starts all over again. If the root to any tree remain intact, cutting down the tree is not going to kill the root. As long as the root is healthy, it will sprout new stems to create a new tree. When you kill the root, the tree is dead. To kill the root to demonic oppression, you must break the covenants, engage in spiritual warfare, repent, and master sin. For example, if the spirit of lust is oppressing you, when you successfully triumph over the spirit of lust, that spirit can no longer control you. Sin is the entryway for all unclean spirits. When you do what is right, sin can no longer control you.
If thou doest well, shalt thou not be accepted? And if thou doest not well, sin lieth at the door, and unto thee shall be his desire, and thou shalt rule over him.
When unclean spirits seek to forge a covenant with you in the spirit realm, the unclean spirits try to get you to break the laws of the Most High through deception. That is why you see yourself doing many vile and crazy things in the spirit realm. It is when you break the laws of the Most High or sin, the unclean spirits get the opportunity to forge the covenant. Israelites, it is important that you understand that unclean spirits do not die. When you are delivered from an unclean spirit, it remains in dry places seeking rest. The unclean spirits are looking for new people to infiltrate. If unclean spirits died when you cast them out, they would not be able to oppress other people. There are countless people under the same demonic oppression. It is of no coincidence that we all have similar dreams. The unclean spirits making their way around the world seeking rest. Every time someone is delivered, the unclean spirits look for someone else to oppress. The Most High reserve harsh judgment for the kingdom of darkness, the lake of fire. The kingdom of darkness know their fate. That is why they are trying to take you with them. Mastering sin does not mean you are sinless. If the spirit of lust is your downfall and you shut all entryway to that spirit, the unclean spirit of lust can no longer control you. When you are a slave to sin, the kingdom of darkness has dominion over you.
Likewise, reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body, that ye should obey it in the lusts thereof. Neither yield ye your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin, but yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead, and your members as instruments of righteousness unto God.
The kingdom of darkness only need an opportunity to flip your world upside down. If you are under consistent demonic oppression, you are a slave to sin. The first step to deliverance is to close the door to sin. Repenting is not only saying, I repent. You have to do the work. If the spirit of lust is your downfall, you cannot engage in activities that will give the spirit of lust permission to oppress you. Israelites, witches, and warlocks know whom they can oppress and who not to touch. Likewise, spirit recognize spirit. Unclean spirits are not going to hang out in the same place with clean spirits or righteousness. The scripture said, what do righteousness have in common with darkness?
Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion hath light with darkness?
Unclean spirits will hang out with other unclean spirits. If you are dealing with the spirit of lust, you will find yourself around other people who are under the same oppression. If the spirit of lust controls a man or a woman, he or she will attract other people with similar spirits. Israelites, that is why it is important that you master sin and look beyond what's in front of you. I often hear people blame other individuals for their setback. My question to you is, what type of spirits are you attracting? The scripture said darkness and righteousness have nothing in common. If harlots are attracted to you, then the lust in you is attracting the unclean spirit in her. A person dealing with the spirit of lust often scold women in general for their clothing choice. The scriptures say a woman should dress in modesty.
In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel, with shamefacedness and sobriety, not with braided hair or gold or pearls or costly array.
I believe men should dress in modest apparel as well. The spirit of lust oppresses women also. The kingdom of darkness do not discriminate. They will use whomever make themselves available. A righteous woman knows she should not dress in provocative clothing. She would not be a righteous woman if she were dressed that way. You should automatically recognize the setup by the kingdom of darkness. It is important that you go beyond the surface and dig deep. The person in the provocative clothing is not the root cause to the spirit of lust tormenting a person. That person already had a relationship with the unclean spirit. Cussing someone out due to the way he or she is dressed is not going to deliver them from the spirit of lust. Attacking flesh is not getting to the root. Remember, unclean spirits travel together. The person in the provocative clothing is also under demonic oppression. He or she is dealing with marine spirits. Marine spirits are the root to all sexual perversion. When you see a person in provocative clothing, that is a marine spirit you're looking at. Remember, spirit recognize spirit. The person who is suffering from the spirit of lust will be attracted to the person with the marine spirits because the root cause to the spirit of lust are marine spirits. When you hear a so-called prominent person or a regular person caught in a scandal with a harlot or a whoremonger, it was due to spirit recognizing spirit. The people involved are attracted to each other because both of them are under the same demonic control. If you are under demonic oppression, you do not attack people, you attack the spirit. When you fight flesh, you will not recognize the culprit, the unclean spirits. Everything is a spirit. When you begin to close the doors that is giving the kingdom of darkness an opportunity, it will get easier for you to say no to the spirits that had a hold on you. Remember, closing the door is when a person repent and stop engaging in activities that welcome unclean spirits. To master sin, you have to ask the Most High for help. You cannot do it alone. If you could, you would not be under demonic oppression. The scriptures say, some have not because they ask not.
Ye lust and have not, ye kill, and desire to have, and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not, because ye ask not. Ye ask and receive not, because ye ask amiss, that ye may consume it upon your lusts.
Asking the Most High for help is a part of repentance. When you begin to shut the door to the activities causing sin in your life, you will find it easier to stop entertaining unclean spirits when they visit you. You will no longer have the desire to do the things that once dominate your life. When Joseph was being tempted by Potiphar's wife, he knew he did not want to sin against the Most High. Joseph made up his mind to serve the Most High. Joseph knew the Most High was with him.
And the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man. and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian.
Israelites, it is important to ask the Most High for help. Yah is the only one who can save you and change your situation. Joseph was aware of the calling he had on his life. He chose not to give in to the temptation, the marine spirit that was on his master's wife, trying to lure him into sin. Joseph rejected all of her advances.
And it came to pass, as she spake to Joseph day by day, that he hearkened not unto her, to lie by her, or to be with her.
When you master sin, you will be able to reject the unclean spirits causing you to sin. When the Most High is involved, you will be delivered. As I stated in the past, you have more victories than failures. When you made up your mind to break free from demonic oppression, it is over for the kingdom of darkness. When you pray and the Most High receive your sacrifice from fasting, whatever spirit oppressing your life has fled the scene. Darkness cannot overpower the light. When a house is infested with insects, most of these insects come out of their hiding place in darkness. Once you turn on the light, the insects flee. In addition, the light exposed the infestation. Likewise, unclean spirits cannot tolerate the light of the Most High. They must flee.
And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not.
To the Israelites who believe your prayers did not work or the Most High did not receive your sacrifice, that is not true. If you fast and pray according to the wisdom and the requirements of the Most High, you were successful. The trouble most Israelites have is the aftermath of spiritual warfare. Most Israelites do not know what to expect after fasting. The real battle begins after you fast. Most Israelites fail and go back into bondage soon after their deliverance. After you fast, you have to guard your mind and spirit. You have to be alert. The kingdom of darkness is going to throw everything at you because the covenants were broken. They want to reestablish the covenants. The unclean spirits will wait for you to make a mistake to attack. The Israelites who are not aware of the kingdom of darkness strategies, they will be deceived by the lies and allow the spirit of fear to traumatize them. Israelites, the kingdom of darkness will never stop pursuing you, especially if you're seeking the Most High with all of your heart and spirit. The kingdom of darkness will try to make your life difficult. You have to be like Joseph and stand firm. It is important that you master sin. When unclean spirit starts to revisit you, you have to cast down all the imaginations that rise against the knowledge of Yah.
Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
Israelites, unclean spirits will come back to revisit you, just as the scriptures state. Remember, spirits do not die. They stay in dry places being tormented until they find a new home. After a fast, if a marine spirit was your oppressor, the marine spirit will begin to send all kinds of temptation your way. The spirit of lust will send men and women that never paid attention to you to pursue you. You'll find dates after dates after dates. An old flame will return to rekindle a friendship. The spirit of poverty will tell you to play the lottery, and many other deceitful things the kingdom of darkness will come up with to tempt you to sin. Israelites, it is through the aftermath you will learn what is truly in your heart. The aftermath is a humbling process for many people. Some Israelites will become frustrated and give up. Other Israelites will gloat in their self-righteousness, while many will realize their problems are bigger than they anticipated and will truly begin to seek the Most High with a pure heart. The aftermath of fasting is when most people will realize how much they depend on the Most High. The Most High do not want his people to boast and say it was through hard work and determination they were delivered. The Most High delivered you.
For by grace are ye saved, through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast.
The Most High is helping his people. The issue is, Israelites do not recognize the Most High's help. In the times we are living in, the Most High is everywhere and speaking. You have to be on one accord with his spirit to hear what he is saying. Do not allow the kingdom of darkness to blind your eyes and close your spiritual ears. The scriptures reveal to us that the Most High is not the author of confusion, but of peace in all the assemblies of his people.
But God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of the saints.
Confusion is a spirit, and that spirit did not come from the Most High. Therefore, we should not submit to the spirit of confusion. The spirit of confusion is causing a lot of distress in the awakening. The spirit of confusion often travels with the spirit of division, strife, envy, hate, and unforgiveness. Where there is confusion brings quarreling and strife. When the people do not know how to settle their dispute, the spirit of division enters to finish where confusion left off. The scriptures inform us a kingdom that is divided or a house divided will not stand.
And Jesus knew their thoughts and said unto them, every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and every city or house divided against itself shall not stand.
Israelites, if the Most High is revealing to you where there is confusion and division, the people will be destroyed, why do we entertain the spirit of confusion and division? If the spirit of division goes unnoticed, the spirit of division opens the door to the spirit of hate and envy. The spirit of unforgiveness finishes the job. Where the people cannot forgive, it prevents their healing. Unforgiveness blocks your prayers. If your prayers are blocked, the Most High is not listening to you. If the Most High is not listening to you, the kingdom of darkness is ruling your world. We are not in the position to be blocked by the Most High. In the physical realm, the spirit of confusion is tearing apart families and nations. The spirit of confusion is causing our people to stumble in the last days. In the physical realm, the kingdom of darkness used the workers of iniquity and trolls to make sure the spirit of confusion maintain its hold in the Israelite community. They unleash these devils in the comment section or live broadcasts on Israelite channels. Many Israelites mistake them for our people. When our people engage with them, they bring forth confusion and division. The Israelite community is plagued with the spirit of confusion. Instead of confusion, the Most High said he gave us peace. If you do not have his perfect peace that surpasses all understanding within and in your assemblies, the Most High is not there.
But the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. For he that in these things serveth Christ is acceptable to God and approved of men. Let us therefore follow after the things which make for peace, and things wherewith one may edify another.
Many Israelites are entertaining the spirit of confusion. Because many people do not know how to combat this spirit, they attack each other, ushering the spirit of division. Israelites, you have to open your eyes to see the kingdom of darkness manipulations. You must be wearing the whole armor of Yah at all times to be prepared for battle. If Israelites were on one accord and the spirit of the Most High was in their assemblies, camps, and churches, the spirit of confusion would not be destroying our people today. The evidence of the spirit of confusion work is everywhere in the Israelite community. This is how the doctrines of devils are being presented to our people. We have to fight against the spirit of confusion. We can no longer allow ourselves to be deceived by this spirit. We must break the covenant from the spirit of confusion and the other spirits that travel with the spirit of confusion. The spirit of confusion show up in the spirit realm in multiple ways. When you have multiple dreams in one night and none of the dreams make sense or flow together, that is the spirit of confusion. When you are oblivious to what is happening in the dream, that is the spirit of confusion. Fire in a negative dream can symbolize the spirit of confusion. When you see chaos in the dream, people running around not knowing what they are doing, that is confusion. You must break the covenants and shut the door to the sins that is giving the spirit of confusion an opportunity. Israelites, your opponent is not the same things and people. It is unclean spirits in the kingdom of darkness that is your opponent. If we want to be successful in the physical and spiritual realm, we have to fight the right target. Fighting your people is not going to resolve the problem. If you have a problem with your people, go to the Most High to resolve the issue. By doing this, you will cast your cares to the Most High and Yah will settle the dispute. There is no need to attack your people. That is giving room to unclean spirits.
Casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you.
The Most High wants his people to understand demonic oppression. We must clean our communities from demonic oppression. All of the problems we face as a people are spiritual. Israelites have a habit of fighting flesh. You have to get out of that mentality. Fighting in the flesh is Satan fighting Satan. If Satan casts out himself, how can his kingdom stand?
And if Satan cast out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand?
It is time that we try something else. Israelites, you will never win fighting in the flesh. The kingdom of darkness is not divided. They are united. If the kingdom of darkness is united, then the so-called righteous people can unite as well. We have to come together as a people to fight against the spirit of confusion and division. The Most High said that he is not the author of confusion. You will not overcome unclean spirits you love to play with. When Israelites starts to look at their conditions with their spiritual eyes, you will begin to see the truth. It takes maturity and the people of the Most High humbling themselves to hear from their Elohim.
Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time.
You cannot be a righteous son or daughter of the Most High and you are walking around with legions of devils plaguing your life. You should be mastering your destiny and devils should be fleeing from your presence. Israelites, examine yourself to see if you produce good fruits. If you seek deliverance, obey your Elohim.
If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land.